Clean, be clean, clean up yourself. And I'm talking about you actually looking after your own estate. Look after your estate, for this is the gift that you have on yourself. Did you think I'm talking about only bathing? No, I'm not talking about just bathing your body. I'm talking about mental hygiene. I'm talking about social hygiene. I'm talking about spiritual hygiene. I'm talking about emotional hygiene. Many people, when they get into relationships, they bring baggages with them. They bring debt with them. And then they expect this other child to be the one who is actually, who must start cleaning this bus. Take note again, a bus is leaving from Cape to Cairo. Big, beautiful bus. It has just left Cape Town. When it's in Cape Town, gets a few passengers. They look so smart and they look so nice. And then when it gets to, Bloemfontein, other passengers go off, new passengers come inside. They bring their cigarettes with them. They start smoking in the bus. They're enjoying their bus. Music is rocking. You have John Vuligate. People are having fun in the bus. Bus moves on further, gets to a place they call Johannesburg. Other people come with their booze. They come in with their gins. They come in with their Savannas and their Coronas. And they also come into the bus and they start drinking. It's getting nicer here. Others are smoking. Others are drinking. Others are trying to look smart and looking intelligent. The bus crosses over to Petersburg. Other people come in with their traditional beers and marula. It crosses over into Zimbabwe in Harare. Other passengers come in. They bring in their traditional drums and everything else. They hit the drums in the bus. You can see it's getting busy now. Get to Lusaka. A new bunch of people are coming inside. Get to Nairobi. Another group of passengers are coming inside. It gets to, right up before it gets to Algeria there, the last passenger who must get on the bus. Then he is told, you are going to pay for the full trip of the bus. The question is, why must I pay for sitting on this bus when all other passengers who have been sitting on this bus were riding for free? Oh, you didn't hear me. Then why must I pay Lobola when everybody has been riding this bus for free? It's not only riding the bus for free. It actually smells. Smells liquor. Smells alcohol. It has permed hair on the windows, lipstick on the windows. Others were puking on the bus. Dust and mud that you collected in Congo. This bus basically is a junkyard full of all sorts of things, smells and people and dirt that is there. And the last passenger is told, you are going to pay 15 cows. You are going to pay 18 cows. Sicela vula mlomo. But when abuvula mahala ngapha, you are opening for free. Now we must start the official thing and someone must start paying. So did you think I'm talking about a bus? And the last passenger on the bus must now clean up the bus. Huh? Sweep the bus. And while he's trying, or while she is trying to sweep this bus, other passengers are saying, Runa ritsamai, ludulemmo. We are not going anywhere. We were sitting in this bus before it even left Cape Town. So why do you want us to leave? These are extra relationships that you are stuck with for the longest of time because you gave these people permission to sit on your bus and do as they please. Can I pass a comment? May you please respect the last passenger. Respect the last passenger, because the last passenger knows the value of that bus. And do you want to give a bus, a dirty bus, to the last passenger? The best way of respecting the last passenger is to respect yourself, so that by the time you're offering the passenger access to this bus, you don't give them as much work. So bath first, clean up your bus, and before you get the passenger onto the bus, hey, it's none of our problems. Don't tell me my previous boyfriend, my previous girlfriend, we were not there. They injured you. It's not us who injured you. They got you pregnant. It's not us who got you pregnant. So your problems, deal with them yourself. Get professional help. Get someone who can clean up the bus for you. Go to professional people. Get psychologists. Get counselors. Clean up yourself as much as you can. And sometimes, even no matter how clean you can clean up the bus, we know some of our young people today, they look so young, 18 years, 21 years, 22 years. And you think that these are brand new cars, 2020 model. Hey, but look at mileage. Look at mileage. 150,000, 200,000 kilometers already done. And this, the model is still 2020. But you look at the odometer, it tells you, hey. And it's finished. You look at the boy, he can't even wake up in the morning, and his small little cable cannot even point. How do you know that a boy is healthy? In the morning, if you find, as a mother, if you find that the toilet is dirty this way and this way, you must know that that boy is healthy. Because it means that at least the cable is still working. And some of our young boys, they are now peeing on their shoes. You can't tell whether this is a fresh banana, or it is now banana juice. It can't even stand. It is just a piece of string that is hanging between their legs. High mileage. Look at our young ladies also. High mileage. The breasts that are supposed to be at 4:15, they are now at 5:30. And now they are looking for fresh marriages. And you wonder, where was this bus traveling all along? And what was it doing on the freeways? Igwelutaka, yongelento. And you wonder, after messing up this vehicle to this extent, and yet you expect when the passenger walks in that they must appreciate the leftovers. This apple has been eaten from the left to the right, from the top to the bottom. It's only a, you know apples have that small little thing on top. It is only that thing that is left and is full of teeth right round. This thing has been eaten, it's almost finished, and you are being told pay for the full price. Pay even for those that ate it. You are going to pay. Now you must start wiping saliva from other people who were busy eating this apple of yours. Who wants to eat apples that have been exposed to so many teeth before they are even bought? So I say it to you, very simple. Please, when you are buying food, all of us, if you find a woman sitting at the mall with a packet of chips, and she has already opened the chips. I'm selling some chips. Can you please buy some chips? Say, yeah, give me the chips. And then she gives you an open packet of chips. You go, hey, first, are you sick? I said, I want my Simba chips closed. He said, no, I was opening for you. No one will eat that. Because you want to take the packet of chips. And it must go poof for yourself. Then you open up the chips and you eat them. Now, if you are so careful about buying chips, if you are so careful about buying clothes, that you don't buy second-hand clothes, you don't buy second-hand food, you don't go to a restaurant to order leftovers, you want to order a fresh meal. If you are so careful about food and dress, how can you be so careless about your life in terms of allowing those that don't mean business to destroy the content, the value, true value of what you are, the essence of who you are? So bath first, clean up yourself. If you have destroyed yourself already, stop. Take some time out. Go back to yourself. Regather your mind. Regather your emotions. And many of the young people and many of the young girls are not getting married. Ask me why. Because they can get sex for free. And the day when they want to make the decisions, most likely they'll have made many wrong decisions.